What's up, YouTube? Capital G here. Looks like the official OCG Forbidden and Limited list has just been revealed and updated, and we are going to cover it and discuss it in this video. I have took special care to make sure that I did not see this FNL list because I like to be surprised. Some of you guys might know what's on it, but I certainly do not. If I had to go for predictions, I would probably go with Nightmare Mermaid to be banned and then Guard Dragon LP. I mean, those are just things that I want out of the game. I feel like everybody has had enough of this whole, you know, Orcus and everything. Also, Guard Dragons, man. But then again, Structure Deck Revolver, they probably want to promote Dragons. Anyways, I think it'll be interesting to see if they do anything to Mystic Mind because of the whole fiasco with the local situations and stuff like that. But this is the official OCG FNL list, guys. It's not a rumor or anything like that. I'm on the official webpage, and let's just go ahead and break it down and see what happens. So, let's scroll down a little slowly. I assume the first couple of cards we're going to see or whatever's at the top are banned. Oh, okay. So first couple of cards banned are Nightmare Mermaid and Gandora. I think Gandora is one of those cards where Konami has tried to hit everything else. They hit Dark Matter Dragon. They've hit so many other different cards instead of hitting Gandora in like the FTK Survived. I know they hit Armageddon Knight to one and it was like, nope, we can still do it with one Armageddon Knights, and Konami is like, they keep trying to go after this FTK without hitting Gandora, and I think they finally just realized, like, let's just get rid of Gandora, then the FTK 100% will not be possible. Looks like they also got rid of Nightmare Mermaid. As I said before, I feel like everybody and their mother is probably just got fatigue from this whole Orcus goes and everything. I feel like, I mean, Orcus is fine. Like, I'm not saying, like, I don't want people playing Orcus. I just don't like people being able to play Orcus Yosinjus and stuff like that. And yes, I have actually seen Orcus Yosinjus. It'll be on my channel. So, I just kind of feel like hitting Nightmare Mermaid still allows people to play Orcus, but at the same time, doesn't allow Orcus in, like, every archetype in Yu-Gi-Oh! So, those are definitely good hits. One hits an FTK, the other hits an oppressive engine that's just everywhere. Looks like okay, so that is apparently all the bans so far. It looks like this might be a smaller list because I know on the last OCG list I believe that Red Eyes was the only card hit, unless I'm mistaken. Anyways, well, banned anyways, let's go ahead and look at the limits. Oh my goodness, whoa. Salaman Great Gazelle is limited to one, and so is Thunder Dragon Colossus. Look, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. And in hindsight, I really wish I would have gotten my top before Salaman Greats got hit. But I did say a long time ago that if a Salaman Great card was ever going to get hit, it was going to be Gazelle. Gazelle is Armageddon Knight. It's the best card in the entire archetype. And once you figure out how to play Salaman Greats, like, you realize that Gazelle's the best card. I said this a long time ago. I was like, God forbid anything in Salaman Greats gets hit, but it will be Gazelle because it's basically the most powerful card. And this is kind of what happens when you take a bunch of banned cards and then just put Salaman Great over their name. Yeah, there are some restrictions, but Konami, you can't give Salaman Great so many banned effects and expect them not to be like insanely good in meta. But even with one copy of Gazelle, considering you can search it from potentially Foxy, Cynet Mining, and also Salaman Great Circle, I kind of feel like, yeah, they won't hard draw it anymore, but they'll still be able to get to it, and you always add it to your hand and your combo. So I feel like Salaman Great with one Gazelle is still perfectly fine. I don't know if they did anything to Lady Debug in the OCG, but if Lady Debug's not hit, then this like doesn't really do any much, or doesn't do very much. We've got Thunder Dragon Colossus. I don't really like this hit. I feel like there are other cards, like Thunder Dragons don't even rely on Colossus that much. Are they really even summoning double Colossus in a turn? Like, I mean, don't get me wrong, it's a strong card, but Thunder Dragons have become so Guard Dragon oriented that like Colossus is almost an afterthought to me. So I kind of feel like that doesn't really, if you're gonna try to hurt Thunder Dragons, that's not the card you want to go after. But that's just my opinion. Anyways, let's see what else happened. Oh, wow, they hit even more Thunder Dragons, and they did hit Lady Debug. Okay, so Lady Debug the one, this is, you know, taken from the TCG. This is something that I also thought was inevitable to happen. It's not because, in my opinion, hitting Lady Debug is not solely because of Salaman Great. Like, yes, right now, it's the only meta deck that uses it. However, to me, it was only a matter of time before Konami gave us another meta Cybers archetype. Like, what happens if Marincest becomes, like, a tier tier one deck. Konami was going to put themselves in a corner where they had all of these, you know, Cybers decks playing like Lady Debug at three, and you know, Konami doesn't really like that. So I kind of feel like if they keep Lady Debug at three, then there's the potential for a lot of these Cybers decks to become kind of like artificially broken. And I feel like it was only a matter of time before the card got hit. This is Thunder Dragon. This is Apex Thunder Dragon, I believe. This is the one that summons from the Banished or from the Graveyard. I believe Jesse Cotton only played one copy of this card anyway. So while regular pure Thunder Dragons, as I call them, Old Guard Thunder Dragons, yeah, it'll definitely hurt you. But unless I'm mistaken, at YCS, not Knoxville, Jesse Cotton only ran one copy of this card, so that leads me to believe that Thunder Dragons will be fine. I think that this is like one of the better ones, but he only ran one of it, so I guess that's my opinion on it. Maybe they don't really need the card that much. And then, oh snap, they hit they hit Metaverse instead of hitting Mystic Mine. Oh man, Konami trolling. So Metaverse is going to one. I guess Konami, look, if you apply the same logic of terraforming to this, I guess you could say that this card is limit worthy. If you're just going to say cap, it's basically terraforming. And there are a bunch of, like, now we're starting to get field spells that aren't just rotas, right? We were in a time during Arc V where we just had a bunch of like field spells that had rota effects in them. And now we're getting ones that have like stun effects in them. And people are using things like Metaverse and Secret Village and, you know, even Necro Valley on their opponent's turn. And I mean, I guess it puts this card in a very unique situation, but I really thought they'd go after Mine instead of Metaverse. But I'm not gonna lie, this is actually a pretty decent hit. Like, I think this is a pretty fair hit. I'll say that it's 100% fair. Whatever terraforming is at, I'm perfectly fine with Metaverse being at the same thing. Even if terraforming went to one and it was at like two in the TCG, if Konami wanted to put this at 1-2, I'd be fine with that. All right, so those are the limits. Let's look at the sim. Oh no, Spiral Quickflix is semi-limited. Oh, that, yikes. That could be scary. I know a lot of people have Spiral kind of out of sight, out of mind. I still believe 100% if Spiral was at full power right now, I think it'd be the best deck. Like, Spiral is so insanely powerful in comparison to, like, other decks that I feel like Konami might be messing with fire here. ABC Dragon Buster to 2. As I've said in the past, Konami and the OCG has they got a weird habit of like hitting cards like these boss monsters and then not restoring them. They did this to Totally Awesome, although now Totally Awesome's not at one anymore. They did this to Dragon Buster. They've done it to cards in the past where instead of hitting cards in the archetype, they just kind of hit the boss monster. It's just weird how Konami and the OCG and TCG see things differently. But a lot of times they'll leave these monsters at one for like forever. They did it with Invoked Merkaba too. Yeah, Invoke Merkaba, they put that to one, and then they just kind of like left it to one for forever. But anyways, Dragon Buster, maybe more people will see ABCs. Quite frankly, I don't know what else could go to two, like meta cards going to two. I feel like two is usually used for restorations, putting cards at two, giving archetypes back more support. Dark Arm Dragon and Dark Greffer. Wow. So if you guys don't know, Dark Arm Dragon has been at one in the TCG and the OCG for a very, very, very long time. I would love to see Dark Arm Dragon at two. I remember the days of Dark Arm Dragon at 3 during Dad Return, and obviously during Teledad it was at 2. Dark Arm Dragon is still an insanely powerful card because it's a GX card. There ain't no hard once returns on it. I would love this. I think that there are so many dark decks because of Konami's just lust to, you know, make darks the best attribute. I think there are so many decks that would be able to use this. Dark Greffer, I just feel like whatever Armageddon Knight is at, you need to put this there too. Armageddon Knight is at one in the TCG and in the OCG. I could make arguments Armageddon Knight should still be banned, but I feel like Dark Greffer at two doesn't really make a lot of sense. I kind of feel like it should be at one. And the TCG, it's at one. I feel like that's a better number. Maybe Konami will eventually get it there, but I don't know. Two Dark Greffer doesn't, like, you have Rota to search these cards, so just put them at one and make it like less consistent. The power of the cards are never going to go down. Dark Greffer and Armageddon Knight are always going to be like super powerful. Keep in mind they still have Malicious at three, unless Malicious is on the semi-limited list on this list. Whoa, we have a Synchro. What is this? Oh no, they hit Dino Wrestler Pancatrops. Holy moly, they hit Dino Wrestler. All right, well, I am going to say, for those of you newer players who don't, maybe you're not going to get this reference, this is what I like to call bottomless trap hole syndrome, right? This is essentially when people play a card as a staple in the main or side deck for a very long time. Konami has a history of doing this. They used to do it a lot during the 5Ds and GX era. They did it to Dimensional Prison. They did it to Bottomless Trap Hole. This is just one of those cards. You guys know Dino Wrestler Pankratrops fits in everything. There's honestly, outside of, even mind decks can play it. Like, there's not really a deck in Yu-Gi-Oh! That can't play Pankratrops. Like, it's just so ridiculously good. I still think if Konami could go back, like, they would have made it a secret rare. It should have been a secret rare, just based on the actual merit of the card. But I'm perfectly fine with this. Honestly, I kind of feel like if you just look at the merit of Pankratrops, this card might end up going to one. It's honestly one of the best side deck cards like ever. TG Hyper Librarian, I don't really, like, I don't know if it's going from one or going to from three. Like, I mean, I guess. Like, I mean, I don't really know if that's going to do anything. Like, is TG Hyper Librarian going to do much in the OCG? Cyberstein and Trishula. Okay, you know, Cyberstein got unbanned in the TCG. It's been unbanned in the OCG for forever. It's not really doing anything. While it is a very powerful card, and it does have some FTKs with dangers in the TCG, it's also a card that, if it gets hand-trapped, you just basically lose the duel in a lot of situations. 5,000 life points. Also, you can't use this like after Destrudo, so there's that. Trishula is a powerful card. Quite frankly, I feel like it should be at three. There are really no decks that can summon Trishula multiple times. The last time I remember people spamming Trishula was with the Infernity turn one play, but that was way back in 5Ds where you Trish your opponent five times before they even got a chance. That required Brionic as well. Brionic has been errated, so it doesn't even work anymore. They did hit Mystic Mind. Okay, so Mystic Mind is at two, which, every Mind deck is still, like, playable. I mean, I guess possibly with Metaverse at one, yeah, you can't, like, super cheese it, but mine at two is still good. And keep in mind, there's still Demise of the Land. I feel like mine, I really thought mine was gonna go to one, but okay, at two, I guess it's tolerable. Necroz Cycle, I believe, was at one for the longest time in the OCG. What are Necroz doing? Like, ain't nobody playing Necroz. Put that card at three. Come on now. And then when it comes to the Unlimits, looks like Dynamite Knuckle, Elemental Hail Stratos, Totally Awesome, which we talked about earlier. And then Spellbook of Knowledge, Ceasefire, and Solemn Judgment. How do they have three Solemn Judgments and we only have one? Seriously, that's like one of the cards that I want most in, most to be unlimited or most to start moving down the ban list. Like, come on, Konami and the TCG. Give us some freaking, like, you know, you understand how good back row decks would be with three Solemn Judgments? It's not like you don't have things like Red Reboot and Harpy's Feather Duster in the OCG to counter this. I mean, it's a high risk, high reward card, but this seems like it's going to be a pretty damn insane format, especially because of, I mean, usually semi-limits don't really affect the game that much, but I don't know, man. I'm looking at these Spiral, Darkon Dragon. This has me excited, and it really seems like for the limits and bans, they kind of just went after Salamence, Great Thunder, Dragons, and Orcus, and obviously the Gandora FTK. What do you guys think? I don't know how long I've been rambling. I'm sorry if I went too long, but whatever you guys think about this, leave it in the comment section below. Thank you guys for watching, as always. Subscribe if you have not already, and turn on that notification bell for daily videos.